Make do it like a risotto. Risotto.
She's my risotto dog.
Sorry.
Do you know where your children are?
Hello and welcome to this live stream. Right now we're gonna continue our first season of a fourth season of this Tour de France. So we're gonna do it. We're gonna have it all day long. So hello, say hello to my little friend. We're gonna start betting, and you have to bet on what please I'm gonna get in the next stage. So can you bet? Place your bets now. Place your bets. And we're gonna continue our race. Stunned it in by. This is the last race of the first stage race. In a hard season, probably the hardest season we're gonna do. And our own guy is dropped out of the race, of course. So. Hello, Carl Philip Felk. Carl Philip Felb, hello. So did you watch today? FUGLSANG was crashing out of the Tour de France. It was so sad. He was itchy to get a go. So let's see. Uh, I don't think we will have a chance to win this. But Fellini could actually have a chance to get a decent place. So we just try to go in a breaker with Askren. Bye bye, baby. Well, this state's race is gonna be. But remember, this is the fourth season, and it's the first season where I actually have to drive to Croatian Tournée, Euro Tour, and Paris Nice. So, what is your favorite for this rest of the Tour France?
The day already confronts the riders. The 1.8-kilometer Côte de Sauta with an average slope of 4.4%.
Yeah, sure. I'm gonna help you. This is gonna be a tough race, tough stage. In many ways. Even this is small states, it's a hard states. It's probably the hardest. And it seems like Balance is gonna go for this polka dot jersey. So we just let him take the next also. Yeah, it's almost 30 degrees now. Oh, it is. And Thursday is gonna be 31. 31 degrees. I was outside earlier today, and the dog was about to die almost. Oh, nice. Well, I think it's hot in the in whole Europe. It's the global warming. This breakaway could go all the way if we're working together, because it's a hilly terrain and these are all tough guys who actually could do something different. The only problem is between the second category climb and the first category climb. There's a lot of flat.
Fourth category. That means 1 point to be earned for the first rider to the top.
What? Nee. Nee. Gar nicht. This is the Mediterranean. Wait, what's this? A wheel? Can you see the wheel outside there? See the background? It's still moving. The water. The water is even moving, even you pause the game. That just shows this game is running on two engines. One with the riders and one with the background. There's no wheel out there. Oh, we could just go further. And we can watch the... Hello? Do you give me some water, please? I have a bunch of guys behind me. Call the police, help me. You want a picture? Just take the picture. It lasts longer. Hello. Hey. What are you doing? Hello. Hello. Talk to me. Hello. You're so ugly. You cannot even sprint out and snail. Huh? Hello. Where are you going? Oh, let's see, this is the rock. You see, the rock is in the game. Whoa, this must be the Mile High Club. You see this? This is the Mile High Club. That must be a sign. What is this? It's like a loser. Nah. What about sunrise? What about rain? Hello? Okay, guys, can you see who I am now? Who am I now? Can you see who I am? What do I look like? I look like Froome. I just look down on my computer. You're so ugly. You cannot even catch me. Two seconds. So let's see, how should we do this? Okay, every time you get to watch a yellow car, you just hit me. You can never catch me. Na 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 na. Well, let's see. Hey guys, you wanna see something? Hey, wait up. Hello? You want a picture? Take it. It'll last longer. Two seconds.
It's a third category climb that now awaits the riders. 2 points will be awarded to the first rider to the top.
It did not go well. Okay, who am I now? I'm still Froome. Who am I now? I'm a guy in trouble. Riding high, we're riding right up to the sky. So, what are we gonna do? We gonna die. Still long states, which can what up? What's up? The heavens up. Yeah, he crashed. He's out of Tour de France. This is a pro leader mode, which we're gonna try to build the team around my rider, and of course trying to do with all Danish riders. So how you doing? Well, I don't think that's gonna be next year. If the rumors are correct, and could be possible because Quintana is gonna leave Movistar this year, is confirmed, and Carapaz is gonna leave Movistar also. So if FUGLSANG is gonna go to Carapaz, FUGLSANG is gonna go to Movistar, then he's not gonna be captain. But Landa is also leaving. So, if FUGLSANG going to Movistar, I don't think he's gonna be captain for the. I don't know. And but next year Froome is also coming back, but I don't think Froome is be the same as he used to be. I'm from Denmark. Like it. In the cab, Denmark. I'm sorry. Like you. So, that's why. And I think I have to turn right here. Is that wrong? Oh, I have to turn right. Okay, you want to see this. Who am I now? I am Froome. I'm watching down my wheel. Ja, rød grød med fløde. Det er nok. What do you want with this flag? Geibel? I think he's behind the pillars. Go find him. Well, shit happens, as you say. But the only problem I have right now is I think he's not gonna drive Wilter. It's too hard for him. Okay, Tour de France 2015. Ah, what not? See. I would say, if I remember correctly, it's the first game with the pro team. So if you buy Valverde, there's two Valverde in the pro team mode and stuff like that. It's kind of soggy. But with Selming, I don't think FUGLSANG is actually driving the Wilter. Not a chance. The climbs is too steep for him. It's too hard for him. Wilter is the problem is with FUGLSANG, because he's not there. You don't see a guy who actually really have in the heart he wants to attack, because he really wants to get at least a stage victory. And here he was also believed he could actually reach the podium still. And why shouldn't he do that like anyone else? There's a lot of guys who haven't got a real bad day. But Jaron Thomas did also crash today. But sadly it was not hard enough. He just crashed on his own. At least FUGLSANG has the excuse to crash, because there are a lot of guys falling in front of him. But Jaron Thomas just fall. But let's see. We have to see. There was nothing broken in his hand. It was just like a... Yeah, his hand was just messed up. Come on, Eskren. You can do it. You can do it. Even this... Only being four climbs still feels like I've gone in mountain states completely. Yeah, they my long time, but it's also 8%. So but there's people dropping off, so it's fine. believe Askren can do something here. He can tie some of the riders out. See, they actually try to attack now because they want the polka dot jersey. And they should get it if they want to. I don't want to waste my energy on this. It's like small ants are just crawling.
We gotta catch that sugar.
So now it's the next downhill and there's one more climb. Okay, single down. He's also in bad form, so it doesn't matter. You should just take it easy and come home. Medus. And we should definitely try to protect him. He's in bad shape also. But it's the only guy we can use for the classification to at least get a top place so we get some points. But this season we have to do it differently. We are recovering. And there's a lot of points to gain for the World Cup. For the world rankings team, but I don't think I'm gonna get too much even I have the white jersey. Because San Carlos probably gonna lose it, but Medus couldn't take it. But we have to see, if you're gonna wait to win the white jersey, you could get like 60 points for the world rankings. And our goal is of course to get top 18 this year. Last year we got a 19th place, but at least we got qualified for the Paris-Nice and Critérium du Dauphiné in Euro Tour, which is actually gonna be a funny race to do, because it's a race this year with two cobblestones at once. And I haven't drove cobblestones at all, and my rider need to get in the cobblestones. This way he can actually be better for it. And now I don't take control of this peloton anymore. After this climb there's gonna come some food, which can actually help my chances to regain energy.
Riders will now follow the road that they took at the start of the stage, but in the opposite direction.
Okay, I think the road is going to go just ahead and then I have to turn right. I don't know why, but I just feel like this. I turn right, boom. Oh. See, that's weird. See, now I have to turn right. I have to turn right each way. That must be a graphic mistake. Oh, this.
Top of the climb will pocket 5 points towards the mountain standings.
I actually think I have video with it. With I think it's Bombilla. Oh, where I have like 30 minutes. Or Jens Vogt, I had 60 minutes and I actually won the stage with 10 minutes. But I think Brambilla had a breakaway on 14 minutes alone, actually. 200 kilometers. And I actually have to keep the yellow jersey for 10 states of fuck because of that. But I lost it to my, I think it was Contador or Slick Brothers. Cannot remember. Okay, this is my last chance for the mountain sprint. See, he's not good enough for these kind of climbs, but we expected that. We only want to have him in a breakaway just to be an outpost. If to come in, and be probably attack now. But it's fine right now. There's gonna come a feeding zone. Okay, nice. Yeah, okay. But didn't the rest catch up? Or maybe just, are you playing on normal or something? Because usually there will always be someone catching up. Oh, he just reaches maximum. And single them, he's dead.
Okay, I'll consume a feed.
But he should not peek in this also, so it's fine. Reaching this you should not think about that, because it's not normal to get a lead on that high. But what is the difficulty of playing? It cannot be legendary at least. Yeah, FUGLSANG is crazy. It's crazy. It just feel like something missing now. It's gonna be weird. At least I think it's gonna be weird. Oh, okay. There was a lot of guys crashing in front of him. And then he crashed, and Magnus Cort say he fly like Superman. Because he just flew like that. with his stomach and arm in front of him. He doesn't have any broken bones, but he just in a lot of pains. He has like a glove or something on his hand now. Right now, you cannot say because it's the first time. It's not the first time the online has been in the game, but it's the first time they actually doing like this. And right now, it all depends on what you think and why you wanna play it online. You cannot invite people, and it's not online in that sense, as I think many people ask for, so you can play against each other in a whole stage race. It's just pure random online, and it crashes every second time. So you cannot see if it's worse, but there are patch coming. I don't know when, but there's a patch coming soon. And you can say the only thing they actually can make this game be more interesting in more than a few months is actually the online part. Or at least make sure when you play pro leader modes, there's gonna come some new riders, and some riders should retire. But it's not like that, so. No, because there's no patch notes. The patch is not released yet, so there's no patch notes. I just know they said they want to fix it. It's because the common patch for the Pro Cycling Manager. It's not because it's the same thing, but they also say once they've been asked about how about this online, and they say the team is working on it and they try to patch it. So I hope this is gonna be released before the weekend. Remember, there's only like 5-6 more days to run this finish. And then people forget about this game. Yeah, I know. But the patch notes for 1.03 is not released yet, as I know. No. This is the standard edition.
Okay, I'll consume a feed.
I never play career mode. There's some stats changes in the patch. 1.02, there's some stats changes, but it's because you updated the national champions. But I never play with a custom. When I play like career, I don't even do that actually. The only thing I'm gonna do is altering teams. If I want to play a Tour of France and I want the real teams, I'll just alter the teams so the right riders and. I did it on my Dauphiné live stream, but then I did not do it in my legendary run with Movistar where I won the Tour of France on legendary mode. Well, I've made a video of it actually. If you watch my my channel, there's a video with real names, and there's not many riders that is fake. It's only like 5 teams. At least it's not the legends this time. Because that was hard to find many of them. But Team Minions, of course, is the right. Cavendish is not right. Quickstep is not right. CCC is not right. Um, And there's one more, I cannot remember what it was. But else you can just go into the different teams, just Google the team name and take the rider page, and usually it's the same same order as in the game. Yeah. Yeah, like legends from the last 35 years, like, yeah, Pinot, yeah, Bobé, Pantani, Franslick, Andislick, Cancellara, Michael Rogers, Bradley Wiggins, Greg LeMond, yeah, you name it, Copy, Merckx, but the problem is with those legends, they're not so attractive to use now, because you cannot unlock them in a pro team. Usually, in the older version, you can actually, if you beat the game on the highest difficulty, you unlock the legendary. And those are usually your opponents, and you can buy the legendaries also. And it just feel like, because now, at this point, if you're gonna beat and you have enough riders, enough money, you can buy like all the captains on all teams, then there's no reason to play. But at least when you have the legendary riders, you still have at least one team. I don't know, we have Bjarne Riis on Eurosport in Denmark and Brian Holm. But I'm more into TV2. So now we reach the first climb. This is actually the first time I drive this state in this race, because last year I actually won it. So yeah, I think they're good. Right now I'm driving with Askren. You can see here. I have Askren. It's fairly good in the hillies, fairly good in the time trials and proto. And they probably, usually they are doing a post update after the Tour de France on what and how they did it on the Tour de France. That means I think a guy like Askren and Krav would probably have even better update than this, and better than the flats. I would say Askren is probably gonna get an update.
Okay, I'll consume a feed.
It's actually funny because Carapaz won the World Championship last season in my game. So he's actually, and he's only a secondary rider on the team for the Movistar. He's a captain in the smaller races, and he's a world champion. He's driving right here. Let's see if we can find him. Yeah, Carapaz, world champion. So he's the world champion now in this year, or this season. So let's see, now we have our last chance to get something out of this stage, because we only have one guy left, and this is Medoyes, and he's not in good shape. And that's gonna be a problem. So I'm not thinking I'm gonna get a top 10 place like I did last year. But at least he can keep the youth jersey, and I hope Askren can Take that. Well, I think it was last year. It was some guy from, I can't remember, but it was weird. Yeah, but I don't think this the stats called luck is in the game. Well, the chance for Fuglsang you should get a podium place is Finnish. He's not gonna get any. He's not gonna get younger. There's a lot of riders on Astana. Next year, Lopez is gonna be captain. He's also much tougher, if I would say. He don't need 7 riders around him. He only need 2 riders. So this is it. The final stage. Final climb.
Okay, I'll protect him.
So let's see how we gonna end up doing this climb. I've never done it before, so I don't know exactly how it's gonna be. We can do it 2 ways, yeah. We're gonna do it. Let's see. Do it.
Okay, I'm coming to protect you.
The riders are now beginning the ascent called the Bassine, close to 12 kilometers climbing that should whittle down the peloton and reduce the number of contenders for stage victory.
Yeah. I would say a guy like Roglic could probably just drive his own pace, but because my rider is not that strong, I have to do it differently. I have actually to be more. Come on, let me get through this. I really hate this when you are stuck like this. Move it, move it. I actually don't think I need to attack. I just need to get in front of this group. Sad when my plan doesn't work like this. So tired. So I have to figure out my plan B. And this is plan B. But again, my objective for this is not to win it, because I don't expect it. It's possible. And Simon's Kolek to have the yellow jersey. Go. Cannellini. Lugiel. Go.
I'll go full out on the relay.
Yeah. At all, but he's not driving anymore. Problem is my I've not make anyone pee in this stage. There will be 10 mountain jersey. So that's why I'm not keen to attack. And I don't think Mountain Court's gonna keep it. I just need to be here to the white jersey. That's my main goal. And his call has been dropped. A red arrow down. It's not good. I don't know. I don't think. The chances not become less after Fuglsang is out, because then he cannot attack anything. And Jaron Thomas, we don't know how much his crash actually hurt him today. He haven't said anything about it. He crashed actually, he crashed on his own. It was so weird the way it crashed. It was the only one to crash. And even didn't look bad. He still hurt his elbow. And that could be a problem. Also think for the Danish news it'd probably be the FUGLSANG crash that has been the highest priority. Slagta, I'm gonna butcher you. Too close.
We're now at the foot of the final climb of the day, the Côte de Lévis. With its 7 kilometer slope, it's ideal terrain for the climbers, but also for some punchers who could let their explosiveness do the talking not far from the line. This last climb is classified as second category. Therefore, the stage winner will score 5 points in the polka dot jersey classification. At 3 kilometers from the finish, there are still several potential stage winners. Less than 2 kilometers from the finish. Final kilometer for the men at the front.
That's fine. I got a 6th place. 7th place. So it's not complete waste. With a bad day for me, it's not bad. That was a good stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome him warmly. He will he's amongst the
What? Did I not get the white Mohovic? Because he won the sprint, he took the white jersey from me. What? Of Di Marchi? Finishing in the top. Oh my god. The stage didn't suit us. That's crazy. Very satisfying. Because Mohovic just beat me. Damn it. God damn it, so I actually didn't get anything out of this.
No.
Okay, we got at least some points. It's not bad because we got 35, so it's fine. And it's better than last year. And at this point, we cannot be... because now we can drive to Paris-Nice. And the guys for this is Krav, Fellini, Petin, Askren, and Pierre Lang is, he's just here. Pierre Lang is just here. And you see there's a windy stage, and then there's a time trial. And then there's a windy stage with some hillies. Okay. Oh, 3 mountains, 3 stages with wind, and the last one is gonna come on a climb. Oh well. See. Now I'm actually not sure that my way to actually get a fitness peak on this was correct. But again, I should just make sure Fellini could actually got go on this. Is good enough for this kind of terrain. Maybe not this one, but this. Because it's a hilly terrain, and that means hilly riders are gonna getting a boost. So, and then I have the sprint challenge, which is my first race for... You see this Euro Tour, 2 cobblestones. 2 cobblestone stages in a row. And then there's a time trial. And then there's a Quartier Duvernay. This is a Pierre Roland. This is gonna be the first time I have to drive with him. And I set him to peak at this point. I have really big ambitions with Medusa and Pierre Roland on this race. And this race should actually decide if I'm gonna go to Tour de France. So the first hilly terrain. When we got to Alder, begin the race. Yeah, I play. Yeah. Replace single them. Single them is not good at this. Single them is actually guy put for the time for the cobblestones. Yo, Patrick. See Asgreen. How? Yeah. Pierre Lang is gonna be our guy, but he's not gonna be the guy that's actually... yeah, but he's not peaking at this. He's not peaking. And there's only one mountain, and I use him, of course. But he has to peak another time. So, because I set him to peace in the Criterium Dauphiné, the same with Pierre Roland. Because that's the race that's gonna decide if I'm gonna get enough points. Because it's with the big guys. See, this is the first time I'm actually gonna drive against guys like this. Piekowski, Alaphilippe, Sagan. The whole dynamic in the race is gonna be completely different now. Completely different. First stage of the Paris-Nice. Without any major obstacles en route, we can expect a showdown between the most explosive elements in the peloton at the top of the Côte de Meudon climb, the finish of a stage that is raced entirely along the roads of the Île-de-France. But I'm probably gonna need him for this. And my guy should just go on a breakaway, and then we put Askren also. See, Fellini is gonna be one of the guys we should use. Yeah, but the Criterium Dauphiné is easier to do because there's mountains. Here, I'm not even sure I would keep it because of the time trial. The time trial can actually kill me. And that's why Fellini is good. And there's no need for me to make mountain riders peak in a race that is actually one mountain stage. With one mountain profile, because if you have a profile, if you have a rider with a mountain profile, he's gonna get a boost on a mountain stage. He's not gonna get a boost on a hilly stage. For the hilly stages, hilly riders are gonna get a boost automatic. That's why. And only the only way I could make it peak correctly is because of the Euro Tour is have two cobblestones in a row, two cobblestone stages in a row. This way, that's the only way I could make the whole thing like yeah, probably can. And he. I will also use him in this, but he cannot defend it, so that'll be foolish. See, a guy like Pierre Roland could be good here. At least you should not like let them drive out and come in shape. And also, there's different. Dynamic is, as I told you, okay. The dynamic is completely different if you have riders like this as favorite for the stage. And remember, I'm playing on Legendary, not Champion mode. There's still a difference.
It's looking good. You've got more than a minute's lead on the peloton.
Riders are looking more ahead now on Legendary than they do on Champion mode. The exit thing, okay, who is dangerous for the clarification? He doesn't really have a strong point that would scare opponents. But yes, I can still win with a guy like Medusa on this. And I want to try, of course.
1 minute 30 over the peloton. It turned out to be a good move.
Can you tap stars not change?
It is not always a good idea to be too many in a breakaway, as the others will not necessarily want to cooperate with us.
He's a rider who can put in a long day's ride. He has no real strengths or weaknesses except the mountains. He's a teammate without ambitions for the overall standings.
He's struggling behind. Two tough machines down there. Okay, I set up the pace now. Do not get up. You don't have contact, not any contact. I don't want them to give contact. You should not get contact.
There's an attack behind.
Siske Bisius.
Don't let the counterattack catch up. The peloton won't let such a large group get away.
Swimming, okay.
Guys, at the beginning of this tour, the sprinters will
and
not
then just don't
away.
Sleep.
If there are more
than
five or six riders in front, the sprinters will get their teammates to ride.
Is that a Hashi? Hashi Laboratorium? Nah, I don't think so. She's not that good anymore. There was a Danish swimmer today who had to swim again to the final to get a final place because he had the same time. So they have to do like a re-swim. I think it's called Antonsen.
There's an attack behind.
Should let them go. Let them get up here. Yeah.
They're riding hard behind. This isn't the moment to relax.
Pentagon.
He's a pure ruler. Make sure you don't leave him alone up front. It would be difficult to catch him, and it's better for him to finish on his own.
Oh no.
It looks like you've got an exit slip from the peloton. It's riding quiet.
Does it look like that? Okay. This is actually kind of weird because they sprinted just before the climb, so what should we go for? No, I did not see. I cannot remember who's crashing when. I only remember the first crash I saw in Tour de France, which was FUGLSANG, and the last crash I saw in Tour de France was FUGLSANG. And then, of course, Ertz and Dimarti.
Let's not forget that in this event, road races include two intermediate sprints, each earning 20 points for the rider who crosses the line first.
Yeah.
He's the best sprinter in the group. Take his wheel if you want to score some points.
Yeah. I can, true, but I want the polka dot. At this point we are in this old church, which is founded just before the First World War. And before the First World War there was no one buried in this. But now we see a lot of people had died in here, that's why there are so many crosses. On the left side you see the new buildings, built by some entrepreneur who had a famous grandmother who was with Napoleon. His granddaughter. Let us see. Yes, I won it.
You are 2 kilometers from the top. You've won the intermediate sprint. Well done. Watch out. You're not going to be able to attack for much longer. Okay, I'll consume a feed.
Ah.
Here's the positions over the last climb.
We got one intermediate sprint and that's nice. Just sit back now, relax and just enjoy. Enjoy this work. It's important I took the sprint there with my own rider, at least.
Avoid any extreme effort.
For some years now, Sepp van Marke is a serious candidate for victory when the Cobbled Classics come around.
I'm gonna stop now.
And third place in the Tour of Flanders in 2000.
And I continue tomorrow with this. I hope I can just do some good results, so, and also get unlock some more stuff from my rider. That would be cool. This way he's gonna be stronger and I can try to work on his mountain stats in the long run. So, but I'm gonna stop right now. Yes, yeah. So, talk to you later.